Alright, so today we're working on this 2006 Dodge Charger. It's our daughter Chloe's car. We actually bought it not working for $200. We had a hole in the windshield, couldn't turn on at all, wouldn't even crank. But I decided I probably could fix it, so took the chance, bought it, $200. And it's a good running car, but it's about time that the water pump went out. It lived past its normal lifespan, so it started leaking. So it's time to change it now, so here we go. In the car runs like crap. There's a connector here for this sensor. To press this fandangle thing in. Son of a gun. Let's see. There we go. That connector's out. Pull this hose off this right here. Just stick it behind the AC nipple, whatever you want to call it. And then get this one loose. 8 millimeter. So I'm gonna take this whole assembly off and put it on the side. Push this out of the way. Fan shroud, which is this piece right here, holds the two electric fans in. Gotta take that out.
First, that one, I'm doing the clip, the harness right here. For the lovely, let's see.
Screwdriver.
Now this one, let's see, it should come out. Oh, there's a little plastic trim piece here.
Feature that back.
Should be rich. Just gotta wiggle it around the radiator holes and the transmission lines. Okay, this one.
Okay. Be careful you don't break things.
Okay.
Let's see. I'll probably attack the belt right here. Take off the serpentine belts. And if you're not sure of the routing, the cars might, I guess only the GMs have the routing on here. It's good to snap a picture or draw it out if you're not sure. Which I'm gonna draw it out right now real quick and we'll get back on the video right after that. And if you come over here and take a look, this car doesn't have it, so I just do a diagram of the belt routing. It's good to know in case your belt flies off on the road and you need to put it back on, so you know which way to put it.
You just put a socket in here and turn it one way or the other, it'll get loose, it'll release the tension on the tensioner. There you go. You slip the belt off of the alternator, is what I need here. And that's off.
Okay. By my belt. Check the belt, make sure it's still good. Any cracks or anything
in the ribs, and there's no meat missing on any of the ribs, so that's a good belt to get.
That's my judgment. I believe I changed this when I purchased the car. Okay,
so
let's
see, next thing we gotta do is remove this tensioner, which is this part right here.
Okay, if I'm not mistaken, let me check the size on that. Should be a single 13 millimeter bolt. 13 or I can't see, is it a 15? It is a 15. Put the socket back in the other. Always put your tools back. It's a pain in the ass when you can't find it. Is still good. I mean, the tension is still good. Okay. No problem here. If you want, when you have all these parts off, you can go ahead and squirt a little bit of something, and you can take this bolt off, put a little bit of grease in there if you want, maybe in there. Not WD-40. WD-40 washes grease off. You want something that will keep the grease in there. Put the bolt in here. This part on the side. So after the tensioner, you gotta take off the idler pulley, which is right here. It has a little dust cover over the fastener. Pry it off, try not to break it. And then that's actually a Torx bit. I believe it's a Torx 40. Let's see how it's correct.
Fall out. The bearing's still good, everything. Let's put it on the side.
Okay, next thing we're gonna do is start draining the radiator. Get my drain pan.
Yep, looks like it.
Okay. I'm lining it up with the, I guess the drain valve or whatever. I don't know the technical term. It's the thing. Where's my pliers?
Right there. That part I gotta turn counterclockwise to get it out.
Let's try.
Okay, next you're gonna take off this hose clamp here for the upper radiator hose. Careful, it's very springy. Sometimes these things are stuck, so you get a dull screwdriver here and try to just leave it in there. And let the hole go. Let me make a special pick for this, but you can usually make it in one screwdriver.
You may want to take it off or not, but
I think you can do it just fine.
So next we're going to work on taking off the upper timing cover. There's a total of 9 10 millimeters that go around. You
keep it on. Two 13s and one 15 that was hidden behind the tensioner. So let's start with the 10, since there's 9 of them. Oh, the 9 millimeters are off. I mean, the 10 millimeters, 9 of them. So next, we're going to take off the 2 15s, 2 13s, and 1 15. Next is the 1 15. We'll be able to start taking off this upper, what's it called? Upper timing cover. This one has a weird fastener in here. It's not typically on this, but let's take it out. And a big bolt on that side. Let's see what's right there. Normally it doesn't have a stud here, but there's a stud here. I don't know what that goes through. It looks like I'm gonna have to take off the whole harmonic geometry and everything first. Now, with everything off, you should be able to wiggle this out, kind of, sort of. There we go. Timing cover. Off.
I'm just getting a little bit of white paint. Any bright color paint helps you see the timing mark if you got a line up. I didn't have enough paint for that.
White out, spray paint, whatever you got works.
So it's easy to see. There we go. Wipe it off and kind of makes it brighter. A little more there.
I don't have the proper tool. I'm not recommending doing this, but this is what I found that works for me. It's a proper tool. I don't know the part of it. It looks like a three-prong ring, a ring with three prongs in it. Kind of goes in and it locks the harmonic balancer from moving. But I don't have the tool, so a pry bar works pretty good. You just need to get it in one of the holes that are in the harmonic balancer. Kind of keep it from turning. And then you hold it with one hand, and you use the other hand, and then you crack the bolt. Once you crack them, usually it comes out pretty easy. It's an 18 millimeter on the harmonic balancer. Next, you gotta set up your 3-jaw pulley to pull that bad boy out. So taking off the harmonic balancer, this is the 3-jaw puller you need right here. It's specific for Chrysler, I believe. But you probably could use it in other harmonic balancers. This is the pin you use so you don't bottom out on the threads. You shove it in the harmonic balancer when the bolt went, and then the drive bolt pushes on this instead of pushing on the threads to get the harmonic balancer puller to work. So basically go like that, put this in there. And these grab on to the openings in the harmonic balancer, and then the action of twisting this in pulls the balancer off like that. And this pin sits here so you don't damage the threads in the engine side.
So that's how the harmonic balancer should look when you got the, I mean the puller should look on the harmonic balancer when you got it set up. It's kind of tricky to put in actually with this style puller. These are all pins that have a little ball. You can just push them in and out. It's a lot easier to just take all the arms out and put them in the harmonic balancer first and put the pulling plate back on after the teeth are just in. And then these are the pins that you put in. There's two different lengths. Basically, so that when you push out, when you insert the bolt to start pulling, it pushes on this instead of the threads of the engine. So for this case, the 2.5 charger takes the longer one. Let's figure out what size it is before I put this in. In this case, it's a 15-16 socket drives this, or you could use a wrench, use a crescent wrench, whatever you want. Just gonna use a ratchet on this one. And start it by hand. Here we go. Always be careful not to damage the radiator. So when you start getting to the end where it's coming real loose, put your hand under the harmonic balancer to keep it from falling. Pin you put in. That's how it looks right here. That's the 3-jaw puller. They go right into those grooves actually. Right there. Like that. So this is the Chrysler harmonic balancer puller. I actually borrowed this from AutoZone. They have a great tool rental policy. You can rent it 90 days free. You just leave them your phone number and a deposit. Because actually I have a ton of tools, but there's just some specific tools that I don't have, and it's not really worth it to buy it if you don't do it all the time. So this was that specialty 3-jaw puller. See it again?
So now that we got the harmonic balancer pulled off, next we're going to take off the lower timing cover. It should be 1, 2, 3, 4 number 10s, and it looks like 1, 15. So let's go ahead and do that. Bingo. Oh, so the next thing I did was take off the timing belt tensioner, pulling tensioner, I guess we call this. It's like a hydraulic little piston. We didn't really show it, but you can't see it with my whole body blocking everything. But this is an old one. This is a new one. See the difference? The new one comes with a pin, and that little center, I guess, pin you could call it, has a lot of force, so don't pull this until you have this installed. Next thing, after the tensioner pin or whatever you call it, you can take off the idler pulley, which is another 15 millimeters. new kit with water pump. This kit came with the new agar pulley and the new tensioner. Hold on, a little bit rusty because the water pump was leaking. So since you're in there, they give it to you, so you might as well change it. Nice, new, shiny. Comes with a new bolt too, but I mean, the old bolt works fine. The new bolt's an Allen head. It's up to you if you want to change it. And then you can go ahead and take your timing belt off, which I already did. Forgot to show you folks that. But basically, when you get the tensioner off and the tensioner and the idler pulley, it's easy enough to just pop it off. Just remember, be gentle. Don't disrupt your timing marks, because then you have a little bit of trouble when you try to start the car. Next, we're going to take off the water pump. You're on the car, so I'm going to show you out here. The timing belt has 10 millimeter bolts that hold it on. It's hard to see, so I'll just show you the old one, what it looks like when I take it off. Another thing that I forgot to point out is they're all 10 millimeter on here, but they're different lengths. And an easy way to figure out or remember where they go, you don't have to mark and put it on a piece of cardboard or anything. The longer bolts will go on any part where you see this raised surface here. That's the longer bolts. Where the bolt is flush, like this, that's the medium length bolts. And if you do have a recess, this one has one, it's actually recessed. How it goes down, that's the shortest bolt. So there's three different sizes. They're all 10 millimeter, but the length is what's different. So if you get them mixed up or if you don't want to keep track, that's easier to remember. Longest bolts go in the raised one, the medium length go in the flush, and the recess is the shortest bolts. Now let's go ahead and take this water pump off. Water. So here's the old one, and you can see when it was installed, it goes down this way, there was water running out here. That means the bearing seal got bad. And if you listen real careful, that means that the bearing definitely went bad. But if you listen to the new one, can't make it make noise. Nothing. So that was a good one. That's a funky bad one. And it shouldn't spin that easy. Here, I was telling you about the recess bolt holes, the flush bolt holes, and the raised ones. Just make sure they're all the same, and it looks like this one is. Yep, looks good.
Dry everything off.
Then before you go ahead and install the new water pump,
always clean off your surface on the engine side, scrape off or clean off any old gasket material that may have stuck on, any rubber from the old seal that got baked on. You want to make sure you get a good seal. If you have to get a scraper, like a flat razor, and clean it off, just to be double sure that it's clean. The last thing you want is a little piece of rubber causing you on. It happens.
This surface in here, make sure it's clean. Okay.